this time I'm going to go over some of the things that probably are causing some problems for you, and also show you some of the benefits to why structured text is a very useful language. Let's look at what I got going here. I've got my trainer panel in factory IO, and I've got a blank routine. First of all, there's a few different ways to ask or to ask if something is true or false, hot or cold, or find out what a value of a tag is. And there's a few ways to set a value on a tag. So let's just start with an if statement. If start one is my push button, green, my top green button here on the trainer. So all I need to do is say if start one. Now if start one is hot, I'll get a positive response. If it's not hot, then I won't get a response. So I can say if start one, then let's do stack green. And then an end if. Okay, so what I said here is if start one is pushed, then stack green. And that's going to give me an error because it's saying stack green what? What do you want me to do with it? So I have to assign a value to it. So that's colon equals, and I'll set it at 1. Okay, now I think that's right. And to check, I want to use my verify routine button at the top here. So verify routine, and I get a bunch of warnings here. And it's because I've got several different routines in here and I'm not using them. So I'm getting warnings that these routines are not accessible from the main routine, or I may have used an output twice. But for now, that part is good. Now I'm going to do one with my counter. My counter is an integer output. So if I say, I'm going to do almost the same line of code. If count, then I'll do stack red equals 1 end if. All right, I have almost the same code. Let me just space this over so we can see. And spaces and returns don't mean anything to the code. Now, let's see what happens when I verify my routine. It's giving me some warnings, and I've got an error. It says line 2, count boolean tag expected. So count is not a boolean tag, it's an integer tag. What I have to do is I have to tell it to look for a value in count. So here I'm going to use count equals 1. I'll check it again. And now I didn't get any errors. I'll just move that up a bit. Okay, no errors. So if it's a boolean, all I have to do is say the tag name, and it assumes I want to know if it's hot. If it's an integer or a real number, I have to tell it to check for a number. And then when I assign something, I can't say stack green and it knows to turn it on. I have to say to turn it on or to turn it off. Now let's try one more. Now I'm going to use if stack green, then, all right, what I'm going to do here is every time it sees that my green light on the stack is on, I'm going to increase my counter. So now I want to do count, and I'm going to assign it the value of count plus 1. And end if. Verify my routine, and I don't get any errors. So here I'm looking at a boolean, even though it's an output. If that green light is on, then my integer is going to be assigned the value of whatever it currently was plus 1. So I'm going to increase my count by 1. And let's go online and see if this works. All right, it's downloaded. Change back to run mode and connect my factory IO. Now, if start one, then stack green should go hot. When I push this button, that green light should go on. And it did. And my counter's going like crazy. So let's see what happens. Okay, so that stack green stayed on. So it's hot, and my counter's just going as fast as it can go. I don't have anything in here to turn that light off. So we'll just leave it. And if count equals 1, then stack red is assigned to 1. So I have no way of putting count back to 1. So I can't turn that red light on or off. Okay, so it's working, but it's not very good logic. Let me go offline and change a couple things. And I'll just take that guy offline too. All right, let's look at what I've got. Here I said, if start one, then stack green is hot. I didn't do anything to turn that light off. So what about I put I'm just going to put some returns in here to make it easier to read my code. Now I've got if start 1, then stack green equals 1. Then I'm going to put an else if. I'm going to put start 1. So here I want to put if not start 1, then stack green equals 0. I'll verify my routine, and I don't get any errors here. And I'll go back online and see if that works better for me. All right, it's downloaded. Change back to run mode. Connect my factory. This time, let's see what happens when I push start 1. So when I pushed it, it went green. When I let go, it went off. Notice my counter, though, it's at 13. I'll push it again. I'll push it real quick. Went to 18. I'm going to push it slowly. Went to 64. The code is scanning very fast, and I only have 9 lines here, so it scans super fast. I cannot push this quick enough to just get a count of 1. Looks like, I think I got a 1 there. But the code scans so fast that I can't push the button quick enough to just ensure I get a count of 1. In that situation, rather than directly triggering my counter, I'm going to have to put a timer in there. So probably what I would do is, here's where I'm working this counter. I'll go offline. So here I said if stack green, then count equals count plus 1. And stack green is staying on long enough that count is increasing by more than just one, and I want it to go up by one. So probably what I would do is I would put a timer in here and put a timer for, say, half a second, and that gives me time to push the button and take my finger off the button, and run the timer for half a second, and then use the done bit from that timer to increment the counter. That would make sure that I only got a count of one each time. Okay, enough of that part. Now I want to look at why do we want to use structured text. I'll open up this guy. And here I've got some code written already. And I know that all this code works because I've tested it. So here I've got a timer, and then I've got some logic to use that timer. So maybe what I want to do is I want to copy just the timer portion. So I'm going to highlight these first three lines, copy, and I'll go over here where I'm going to update my counter. And I'll paste in my timer. Now, one thing I'm missing is I don't have any of my if statements from the other code, but I'm going to use this one. So I don't want to use the same timer, so I'm going to change that to timer 2. And I get the little squiggly red lines under it. And that's because, I'll right-click on it, undefined tag, timer 2. So I need to define the tag. I'll right-click, new tag for timer 2, and it's an FBD timer, hit create. Now I have a timer called timer 2. Here I need to change this to a 2, and I need to change that to timer 2, and that to timer 2. Okay, now I've got my timer 2. I'm going to change that to 3 one-thousandths of a second, or 3.3 seconds. And the reset can be the done bit. That's all right. I need to enable it. Let's see how I enabled it before. Where is it? Here's my timer 1, timer enable. All right, what I'm doing there, I'll just copy that guy because I don't want to use that. Timer 2, timer enable, and if I assign it the value of 1, that means it's just always on. I don't want it to be always on. I want to use this green light, stack green, to start my timer. Here I'm going to say if timer 2, timer enable equals stack green, or not if, but timer enable is stack green. So each time that stack green goes hot, I'm going to enable my timer. And then here, instead of using stack green to adjust my count, I want to use timer 2 dot done. Now my timer 2 done bit will initiate that count. It takes a third of a second for it to time through, so that gives me time to take my finger off the button, or at least it should. I'll verify the routine and no errors, so I'm going to go online and test that. Okay, I'm downloaded. Go back to run mode. Reconnect factory IO. And now, if I push start one, my stack green should go hot. And when it goes hot, it'll start that timer. When the timer finishes, it should increase my count by 1. Right now it says 4. I'll push it. And it still says 4. Now it says 5. So something's going on with my code, and I can't see what these are doing, so I need to turn on the values. And let's see if this will tell me. Well, I'm back. I had to make a few fixes. And what I'm doing here is I'm using a timer to delay when my counter is updated. And I had a bit of a struggle with it because as soon as I took my finger off the button, I'm using this start one button. As soon as I took my finger off the button, my timer would stop, and so my code wouldn't work. I had to make a little adjustment here in this line. With my timer to timer enable, I'm using two different things to enable it. First, I'm using my stack green. So anytime that green light is on, it'll enable that timer. Or the other thing that can enable the timer is if the timer itself is running. Once you start the timer, it's going to keep running and it's going to do its thing. Let's go online and see how it works. That's downloaded. Change back to run mode. Connect factory IO. And now when I push start one, the green light goes on and my counter increments. And if I leave my finger on the button more than a third of the second, I still get the problem of incrementing too much. Maybe a third of a second is not enough. I'm a little slow on the button. If I just give it a click, then it's going up by one. So that's working pretty good. All right, the last thing I want to show you about structured text that makes it real useful is I'll go over to this code that I wrote a little while ago. And here I've got 50 lines of code. When you're writing your code, you might have hundreds of lines, and you might want to work on just one section of your code. You might want to turn everything else off and just work on that one section. For example, maybe I want to work just on this. To do that, all I need to do is highlight everything I don't want. So I've highlighted that and I'm going to click on comment text block. That changes that all to comments, and I'll do the same thing down here. And that changes all that to comments. Now the only code I have here is this one section in the middle. And I can work on that and make sure that little piece is working. Once I get that all figured out, I just have to highlight this other stuff again and go back up here to uncomment text. And it changes it back the way it was. And I'll go do the same over here. There, now I'm back the way it was. It's a real nice way to be able to isolate parts of your code to work on it and then go back and unisolate it if you want to work on just part of it. Okay, that's all for this tutorial, and thanks for watching. Talk to you later.